it shouldn't really be much of a debate. The statute that sets up the military commissions that we have now makes it unlawful to try an American citizen before them. End of discussion.
So when you heard the state senator on earlier demanding the right to torture this man, what was your reaction to that?
Come on. We don't torture. Torture is illegal under U.S. statute. I know of no instance in which anybody has committed officially sanctioned torture.
Well, we know President Bush sanctioned waterboarding, right?
Yes.
On three occasions, I think.
Yes.
But that doesn't legally qualify as torture, is that correct?
Correct. In fact, there are OLC memos describing precisely what the torture statute says and why it's not. Torture statute says it's unlawful to act under color of law to impose severe physical or mental pain or suffering. And severe physical pain or suffering isn't defined. Severe mental pain or suffering is defined in durational terms. And waterboarding has been used and is used to train U.S. Special Forces and SEALs. It is not torture.
I mean, vulgar though Senator Ball was throughout that extraordinary exchange, there will be people watching, and there'll be many Americans who feel, yeah, I've got no problem with taking this guy, Joe Tsarnaev, out the back and roughing him up a bit if it reveals information about potentially other terror attacks he may have knowledge of. What do you say to them, given that he is an American citizen who committed a crime on American soil?
What I say to them is that the rough stuff is, let's put that aside for a minute. There is nothing to stop the president from sending in a group of people, be they FBI agents or Defense Intelligence Agency people or military people, to interrogate him in any fashion short of something illegal in order to get intelligence, provided that that's not used in connection with his criminal case. Mm-hmm. They could do that even after he was indicted.
So they can do that at any time, even after they've read him his Miranda rights?
That's my view.
So the Miranda rights changes nothing in terms of their ability to interrogate?
What it changes is their ability to question him and use any statements that he makes. Mm. That they're not allowed to do.
He is apparently claiming...
But they don't need that in this case. I mean, they got a mountain of evidence against this guy.
Right. They have the evidence, it seems, against him and his brother for the act they perpetrated.
Correct.
What they will, I'm sure, be extremely curious to find out, if they can, is are they part of a wider group of either like-minded individuals who've been coordinating themselves, reading stuff on the internet, videos and so on, which apparently what he's claiming, whether they're attached to anybody in Chechnya, for example, of an Islamic fundamentalist nature, etc., etc. How far can you go in terms of elucidating that information from somebody like him in his position once he's had his Miranda rights read to him, as he now has?
My view is you can go as far as you think it's productive to go. However, I don't think it's terribly productive to question him beyond a few questions about unless he's freely talking, which I seriously doubt. I think it's far more productive to exploit things like electronic records, like their personal computers and so forth. Bank records, telephone records, that sort of thing is going to disclose a lot more than he will, I think.
Does he have any kind of defense that you could, at the moment, draw up?
Well, the mitigation strategy is my big brother made me do it.
Right. Is that remotely plausible as a defense strategy?
As a defense? No. It can be used to keep him off the table where they give you the needle, I suppose.